Over the last year, the COVID-19 pandemic has affected nearly every aspect of our daily lives. For those who have lost jobs or had other financial hardships, it can be difficult to afford food for each meal of the day. In Franklin County, Stone Soup Cafe is helping those with food insecurity each Saturday by offering a restaurant-quality meal at a pay-what-you-can price. Connecting Point's Ross Lippman visited the cafe recently to see how Stone Soup offers meals to those in need.
It's the last weekend in February, and it's snowing. Again. But come rain, sleet, or any weather of any kind, at Stone Soup Cafe in Greenfield on Saturdays, you can find Kirsten Levitt.
Yes, boiling.
In the kitchen, making lunch.
Everything here is like a dance.
Levitt is executive director and head chef.
Send me people that are ready to do chopping of the mushrooms, because I want that liquid too.
Of the pay what you can style restaurant, situated inside the All Souls Unitarian Universalist Church.
We're not a soup kitchen. This is a meal for everybody. We believe that everybody should access the meal, and those who can pay should, if they can. And those who can't are welcome to partake of delicious restaurant quality food.
On this particular Saturday, where the menu celebrates the Lunar New Year,
I'm here alone because I've sent everybody out there.
Is the cafe's busiest and most popular.
Today we're gonna do close to 500.
With 500 meals to serve, the clock is always ticking.
We'll add all of the stir-fried vegetables to this.
And Levitt's team of volunteers are moving fast.
There's like a big hustle that starts all at once and everyone kind of snaps into action.
Stone Soup Cafe certainly isn't immune to the financial repercussions of the pandemic, as restaurants across the country close either permanently or temporarily. This Pay What You Can Cafe has found a way to stay open, and it's more important now than ever. With food insecurity increasing, they're able to serve residents here in Greenfield and in the surrounding towns across Franklin County.
We pivoted very quickly. We immediately responded to the community's needs. People saw us step up and respond, and that was a really big deal.
Big enough that between various COVID relief grants and community donations, Stone Soup has kept up as the cafe's budget doubled to $250,000 within the last year. But every dollar goes back into the food for more vegetables, more noodles, and more to-go boxes.
Is this first tray going over to Lisa?
The pandemic forcing the cafe to rethink how it serves its growing lines, now waiting outside.
This process, there's about 7 people on the line, and we have 2 people packing meals, 2 people handing out meals, and we have 4 people on the line taking orders.
You want some cereal to go?
The cafe also runs a food pantry, which is stocked weekly.
Excellent.
Thank you.
Yeah, nice to see you.
No one leaves without a meal, even when they can't be found.
Hey, Amy. So, I'm looking for Jonathan. Did we see where he ran off to? He's usually waiting across the street.
And if you can't come to the cafe will come to you. Volunteers like Shannon Prescott and her daughters Layla and Amelia are piloting Stone Soup's new delivery service.
Stone Soup,
thank you.
You're welcome, enjoy.
You too.
Thanks.
When the pandemic hit, the very first thing we knew was what people needed delivered meals. So we opened up that whole new program.
As Stone Soup continues to adapt to life during and after COVID, Levitt says they're now thinking long term.
So that's going to be for soup.
She doesn't see the demand for meals going down anytime soon.
In rural Franklin County, the economic hit from all of the unemployment, from the changes that the pandemic wrought, the recovery from that will take longer.